Welcome, everyone. This is the WNBA on 2K Sports. Tonight, it'll be the New York Liberty going up against the Phoenix Mercury. With analysts Brian Banifatemi and Tim Swartz, I'm Blake Suniga, and we're glad to have you with us. And so off the tip, it's Phoenix. And right now, injuries taking effect for some teams. But it's hard to pay your stars and maintain a deep bench all under the salary cap.
Yeah, having rookies on smaller deals always helps out because hitting on draft picks is never easy. But if you can, you have a huge leg up on the rest of the league.
And a coaching staff that is creative helps as well. If you lose a star, figure out ways to get others involved. The other thing, too, the underrated part, the locker room, staying together is important. A positive attitude can go a long way.
Impressive mobility from Boyd. She can be shifty when driving to the basket.
Pass to Bonner. Now Griner. And here is Carson, covered by Zowie B. Shot clock at five. And here's Diana Taurasi from the arc. Nurse outside. And she banks in the layup.
Great piece of work to get to the hoop. She tore the D to shreds.
They really want to find that igniter here.
That's right. Their offense is ground to a standstill.
Maybe you need to suit up, Tim. They need a spark. Here's Turner. Back to Taurasi. Score the basket. Nice shot after missing her first attempt.
A strong personality with great confidence. Taurasi will not back down from contested shots.
Pass to Nurse. Here's Charles. She's covered by Taurasi. Over to the left wing. Here's Boyd. That falls. Nice feed that time from Tina Charles.
She's really one of the best passing bigs in the league. Charles had a year where she averaged just about four dimes per game.
Carson, guarded by Durr. Griner with the ball. Diana Taurasi on the wing. Drills the elbow jumper.
Such a well-rounded offensive player. She's got a little bit of everything.
Outside Boyd. Nurse outside. And the foul called on Griner. That is her first foul of the game. Just over 2.5 minutes played here in the first quarter. Nurse outside. Shoots over Bonner. A shot by Nurse, no good. The Mercury trail. Griner's shot is good.
In the paint, Griner simply unstoppable. She's so tall at 6'9", but she also has lovely touch.
Now here's Boyd. Pass to Nurse. Back to Boyd. It's blocked by Brittany Griner.
Length and vertical jumping ability pay monster dividends for Griner as a rim protector. Coach has always told me that if you battle for offensive rebounds, you're guaranteed a high-quality shot on the follow, just like she got there.
Taurasi outside. Solid play on the low block, and that one's good.
She's looking good. 3 of 4 so far.
Pass to Zowie B. Now here's Nurse. Outside Durr. Back to Nurse. For three! That one doesn't drop. Now Phoenix takes it the other way. Turner, Griner with the ball.
They now take the lead.
It's so nice to have somebody who can take charge, take the offense like she has.
Well, they got to be feeling good about having the ball in her hands right now. I mean, she's just making play after play.
Now here's Durr.
Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her.
One of the more unselfish young players in the league, Asia Durr. Her college coach once said that she would come out of halftime and sometimes ask, did I shoot too much? She just wants to be a great teammate, and I admire that.
Six on the shot clock. Reiner misses. New York trailing here.
Here's Nurse.
And it's good. Fought through the contact, hit the shot, and she'll go to the line.
Well, Durr is certainly a player that always puts the team's success over her individual success. How important is that for team chemistry?
Oh, Blake, I gotta say it's huge because it helps your teammates play looser and more free because they know what they can expect from you, and that mindset is contagious. So when everyone else catches on, big things can happen.
And one of the best players in the WNBA, Diana Taurasi, in action tonight, the former MVP. She does it all on the wing, one of the most dominant players ever.
Now here's Bonner. Here's Griner. Amanda Zawibi with the block. Here's Durr.
Uses the glass to finish the layup.
And with Taurasi, she is at her best when the stakes are at their highest.
Look, Taurasi has multiple finals MVP awards, and that speaks to that mindset you were talking about. And she's been compared to Kobe and Jordan for her impact on the league. That's the kind of generational player Diana Taurasi is.
Now Nurse. She has five. Here's Charles.
Well, Tina Charles has had lots of great years in the league, but 2012 was arguably her finest. Charles averaged double-double, garnering MVP honors for Connecticut.
This is her first opportunity at the line this evening.
Free throw, no good.
What a year she had back in 2012. Charles was the WNBA MVP, going for 18-10. But also defensively, she was second in the league in blocks, showing her dominance on both sides.
And she sinks the second. And so here's Phoenix, trailing by two. Pass to Griner. The rebound by the Liberty.
Yeah, for Charles in 2012, winning MVP in just her third year in the league.
And guys, she carried Connecticut, leading the team in points, rebounds, and blocks. And she helped the Sun finish 25-9, owning the best record in the East.
Now here's Taurasi. She's got eight. Foul call that time on the way up, and that'll give her two chances at the free throw line.
Way to get to the line. Griner lives off not just getting to the line, but she shoots over 80% at the line, too. Just a one-of-a-kind player. Brittany Griner is the all-time leader in dunks at every level. High school, college, pros. She's not just 6'9". She can really jump.
The first one falls.
We've never seen a WNBA player like Griner before. She has great lift, Brian.
Yeah, and it really started back in high school in Texas because as a sophomore, she worked out with the football team to improve her leg strength. And really, any way you look at it, Brittany Griner is a once-in-a-generation type of talent.
Fellas, I don't think it's a stretch to say Brittany Griner is the most dominant defensive player ever in the WNBA. Standing at 6'9", with length, she just owns the paint.
Now here's Charles. There's the foul. It's on Little. That is her first foul of the game. And the Liberty with possession here. Pass to Johannes. Hartley. Clock at 6. And stolen by Deanna Taurasi. And up the court come the Mercury on the break. And no good. Had a chance to take the lead. Griner is so intimidating down low. The multiple-time Defensive Player of the Year changes a game.
Absolutely, Blake. I mean, Griner forces opposing teams to alter their game plan, and she's been doing this from the jump. I hope you guys remember when she led the league in blocks as a rookie.
Well, the New York Liberty, a marquee franchise in the WNBA, one of the chartered teams in the league, but unfortunately, they're still looking for their first title.
And with the Liberty, as you said, that first championship, something they are searching for.
New York has come close several times. They've played in 4 WNBA finals, and this team is desperate for a banner, but it just hasn't been in the cards for them.
And she makes the first. So she hits both.
Well, the big three of the Mercury, as impressive as any in the league, Griner, Taurasi, and Bonner make quite the trio, and really any three of them can take over a game with scoring at any time.
Now here's Little. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Now here's Gray, covered by Little. Gray outside. No good that time. And it's Phoenix the other way. And with the core of this Mercury team, they are a threat every year.
Well, with that trio, they are always a threat. They've got great balance between them for inside and outside play. Hard to think of a better big three.
And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good, and she'll go to the line. And the free throw, no good.
Whether it was a shoulder surgery, an ACL tear, Breonna Turner dealt with a lot during her collegiate basketball career. But she always remained locked in on rehabbing and keeping her hoops dreams alive.
Now here's Taurasi. 8 points for her. To the middle. That one's in, coming off an assist from Leilani Mitchell.
And she's having a quarter, converting at a high percentage.
New York leading. Well, Brian, bouncing back from injuries late in her college career, what can a healthy Breonna Turner bring to the court?
Yeah, it's great to see her bounce back from those injuries she suffered, but she's exceptional on defense. it's Blake, whether it's rebounding the ball or swatting shots away. Now, she has everything she needs to be a great player in this league, and I'm rooting for her.
Here's Johannes. Pass to right. Charles. Tries a three. Hartley's shot is off.
Great rebound there, but they haven't been very strong on the glass so far. Let's see if they can change that.
Yeah, a little disparity there in the rebounding numbers, but some of that comes down to how the ball bounces. We'll see if it evens out.
That's the third bucket in a row from the paint. And I know nobody likes a traffic jam, but this defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Yeah, nobody likes a traffic jam. We can agree on that. They can't allow the offense to get those high-quality looks inside.
Shot and game clock separated by five. And Little gets it to go.
What a passer. Diana Taurasi sees the game like few ever have. Finds teammates in great positions.
Here's Johannes. That's in, and she found her range with that one. Now one for two.
That's an impressive spin move there. I didn't know she had handles like that.
Here's Taurasi, and the Mercury tack on two more.
Enjoy it. Went on, no one scores like Diana Taurasi. She has the most 20-plus point seasons in league history.
And still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Mercury out in front, up three. Stay with us as we get set to bring you quarter number two after this. Close game here at the start of the second quarter to play. And what do you guys think about the Mercury here in this one?
There hasn't been a lot of settling for outside shots really early on.
Yeah, they've done a good job to work it low and not take the easy way out on offense. No shortcuts.
Pound it low.
New York trailing here.
Tight team, tight team.
Right outside. Pass to Johannes. And that's a foul called on Diana Taurasi. That's foul number two for her. Here's Johannes. Pass to Hartley. Just five on the clock. The long three. Mercury with the rebound. Mitchell outside. Fires. And the Mercury tack on two more. And it's New York's ball. It's a five-point game. Here's Johannes, covered by Little. Camille Little with the block. A one-on-one situation. And she floats it in for the easy two. Credit the assist on that one.
Nice job again that time to add to their lead. They're doing everything right at the moment.
Yeah, you're right, Tim. It's something that any basketball fan will appreciate. It's just good, steady basketball that are playing in all aspects of the game right now.
Now here's Hartley. The shot that time, not on target. Excellent D there from Leilani Mitchell. Little outside. Back to Mitchell. Shot clock at 6. Launches it. Johannes with the rebound. On offense, here the Liberty. Still looking for their first basket since the first quarter. Hartley outside. But they'll get another chance. Right wing. New York, no good that time either.
Just like me, 9 times out of 10, she's gonna bury the 3 when she's left all alone like that.
So it's both teams making substitutions here. And here in the second quarter of action with a hair under 2.5 minutes played. Just 5 to shoot. Turner. And she makes good on the layup.
These defenders look overmatched right now, especially inside.
Well, they've given up 10 of the last 12 points from close range, so I'd have to agree.
Now here's Boyd. Over to the wing. They need this. Here's Zowie B. And the shot counts. She's fouled. That's a chance for a 3-point play.
That's a great play in the glass. And for her, it's what really we expect from her. All her second chance points do not come by accident. And a chance here to see the incredible Tina Charles in action. Former MVP, she won the award in 2012. Without a doubt, the leader of the New York Liberty.
Here's Turner. Bonner inside. Gray defending. Outside Carson. Back to Bonner. Amanda Zawi B with the block. Good on the shot.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now. I mean, there's more holes in their defense than in a block of Swiss cheese.
Man, you just made me hungry, but that's right. 5 of their last 6 makes were in tight. They've established themselves inside. Where's the cheese?
Well, to be a good offensive rebounder, you have to really hustle, and Gray certainly has a full grasp of that.
And with Tina Charles, she has always been great and proved her defense recently.
And the defensive improvement goes hand in hand with her rebounding. Always been one of the best rebounders in the league, but now she gives you everything you want on the block.
Reiner controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Well, to me, it's clear that the difference in this quarter has been their dominance on the offensive boards.
Plenty of second chance points, not resting on their lead. They're staying active.
Now here's Durr. Nurse, right side. Brittany Griner with a defensive effort.
Terrific job defending the basket that time. It's not an easy task stopping her when she's headed to the rim.
Back to Carson. Hey, Turner, Boyd covering. Pass to Bonner. Hey. Poked away. In transition, here come the Liberty. A nice shot by Boyd.
Garnering so much attention from the defense herself, so Durr plays with her head up and finds open teammates.
Here's Turner. Now Carson.
Now Griner. Gray defending.
It's Leilani Mitchell on the wing.
With the shot. That shot, no good. And New York will come the other way. Down low, Boyd. Good D by DeJuana Bonner.
Well, this is why you need good defenders inside contesting shots.
Yeah, making every shot a tough shot, even in tight.
And that one drops for her.
She's picked it up since the start of the second. Her shots are starting to fall.
New York calls timeout.
Well, what an incredible 2018 DeJuana Bonner had, making it to her second All-Star team and almost making it to the WNBA Finals. And you know what makes it even more special, guys? She missed 2017 due to pregnancy.
The Liberty Trail. And Tim, we've seen players miss a year before. Sometimes they come back the same. Amazingly, Bonner came back better.
And it culminated in that playoff run. Bonner averaged 24 per game, played almost 39 minutes per game. I think I'm speaking on behalf of the entire league. We are so happy she's back in the WNBA.
Now here's Mitchell. Bonner outside. Back to Carson. Pass to Turner. Now Griner. Five to shoot. And she wills that one in, sinking right through off the back iron.
A valuable offensive talent. Griner's agile, and really the whole league knows it.
Here's Durr. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot, and will shoot two at the line.
Well, one player that immediately comes to mind when I think of relentless work ethics is Asia Durr. Now, she's always working on her game, and throughout her life, coaches have actually had to force her to train less.
First one falls for her. And you talk about the work Durr puts into her craft. How important is a good work ethic for a young talent like her, Tim?
Oh, it's critical, Blake. Always important to establish early on that you're in it to win it. You want to earn the trust of your teammates and coaches, and working tirelessly will do that for you.
Second free throw, no good.
Well, free throws are definitely not a weakness in Durr's game. Durr is just a player that doesn't want any holes in her game.
Now here's Nurse. She has seven. Pass to Durr. And here's Zowie B. Now here's Nurse. Over Mitchell. The shot by Nurse, no good.
Well, that's just not a sight you see very often, because she has a great feel for that jump shot, especially when she's open.
Bonner, good.
She isn't a real elite three-point shooter, but Bonner hitting shots like that, it changes how the D plays. They have to respect that and come out every now and then.
Now here's Nurse. Missed inside.
Her shooting numbers slipping this quarter.
Away. Mitchell defended by Nurse. Pass to Carson. Here's Turner, guarded by Durr. In transition, here come the Liberty.
looking to get back on track, and Nurse with the layup.
Running effective pick and rolls is only a small part of what makes Boyd a premier point guard in this league.
Now here's Carson. She's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Pass to Mitchell. Bonner right side, six to shoot. Great D that time from Tina Charles. Now here's Nurse. She's guarded closely. Good.
That's incredibly poor defensive awareness. She's one player you don't want to give up any space to.
Now here's Griner. Pass to Turner. Boyd on the double team. Inside. Here's Mitchell. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the line.
Another pass put right into the shooter's pocket for a terrific assist. You know, they've done a lot of that today.
And you know, it's something we haven't seen much at the opposite end of the court.
And this is her first trip to the line tonight. Here's Johannes. Nurse outside. And the foul called on Griner. That is her third foul so far.
And that's the risk they ran by keeping her on the floor. She picks up her third foul.
Hartley outside. Zowie B. Five on the clock. From way back. Mercury with the rebound.
Not really sure if they're aware of the 2-for-1 opportunity they have.
They ought to be.
To the left wing. Little with it. Zowie B on her. Little's shot is off. And even 3-on-3 break. 3 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Rejected by DeWanna Bonner. And so it looks like Liberty will retain possession here. And the Mercury making a change here.
Brianna Turner.
Here's Johannes. She's covered by Taurasi. Pass to right. Clock at six, out to the left wing. And again, it's the Liberty missing. Here's Little. And no good trying to get that one. That'll do it for the first half. It's the Mercury up by 9. And time now for the halftime break with the third quarter soon to follow on 2K Sports. We'll be right back.
And now the third quarter about to get going again. And, you know, Griner has been really making it happen here.
She broke out her entire arsenal of post moves in the first half, and every one of them was working.
Yeah, and I'm going to call her the magician because I think she might have even a few more tricks up her sleeve, and I think she's going to break them out as we start heading down the stretch.
All right, the second half beginning in a moment. New York trailing here.
Well, Brittany Griner, one of the biggest names in the WNBA, and standing at 6'9", she's a dominant center in every sense of the word, and she just does everything you want from a two-way star.
Well, controlling the boards, they're +5 in that category.
Yeah, and look, rebounding, it's not a glamour stat, but you look at the scoreboard and you see the result.
Now, here's Griner. Taurasi, defended by Nurse. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Carson, no luck on that one.
She got ahead of herself there and just lost her concentration. At least that's what I think.
And 2 free throws coming up as she misses that one. Drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. It's on Diana Taurasi.
A top 10 pick out of Connecticut. Kia Nurse comes from a family of athletes. Her father played pro football. Her mother, hockey. She's a great competitor growing up with sports in her family.
And the first one drops. And with Griner, she initially gained notoriety for her dunking.
I mean, one of the few players who regularly throws it down. And that's not all to Brittany Griner's game, though. She has great length, great touch, and uses both to get scores right over defender.
And she makes both free throws. Phoenix leading. Poked away. Taurasi outside. Griner. Turner. Boyd covering. Basket good.
Ooh, an unselfish play from an unselfish player. Griner is a respected locker room figure.
Now here's Boyd. She's got 6. Pass to Durr. Now here's Charles. Carson covering. Here's Nurse. Griner with the rebound.
They are really getting the work done inside with their rebounding, Tim.
They haven't allowed many second chances. It's been one and done for the most part, and that's helped them build this lead. Lighting it up again, Griner led the WNBA in scoring for a reason. She's expanded her offensive game.
Pass to Durr. Charles. Shoots over Taurasi. Charles, no good.
They start the second half with 3 straight misses.
To the inside, and stolen by Charles. And they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score.
Durr with it. Pass to Charles. Nurse, 6 on the shot clock from deep. Great D that time from DeWanna Bonner.
A donut, a 0 so far to start the second half. 4 straight misses.
Got a piece of it. Here's Carson. Banked in off the glass.
4 of their last 5 makes came off a high-quality shot inside.
And that's right out of the textbook. They are having their way down low right now.
Now here's Boyd. She's got 6. Pass to Charles. Nurse with it. He's against Bonner. A shot by Nurse, no good.
Bodied her up and made her alter the trajectory of the shot that time.
Definitely. Some very sound defense played on that trip down.
Here's Carson. To the paint. Griner, guarded by Durr. Outside Carson. Pass to Griner. Shot from 12. That shot off. And it's the Liberty taking it the other way. Right side, Durr. Nice pass. Led him to the rack perfectly for the layup.
known more for her shooting than her finishing, but don't you dare sleep on Durr's touch around the basket.
Stolen by Brittany Boyd. And they're going to count the bucket and send her to the line. It could be a three-point play. Second half here, and we're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Pass to Turner. Back to Taurasi. Reiner. Here's Turner. Five to shoot. And again, Phoenix no good.
She has not been able to get into that groove yet, guys, but as a whole, it really hasn't affected the team that much. That pass led her so perfectly, she didn't even have to break stride. When I think of players who have really improved as rebounders, I immediately think of Rashonda Gray. Early in her WNBA career, she wasn't putting up the biggest numbers, but with more minutes nowadays, she's been putting in work.
Now here's Boyd. 8 points for her. Gray with it. Outside Boyd. Zowie B. She's guarded by Griner. Again, the Liberty good for two.
Yeah, and Gray has certainly become more developed in the rebounding department. Now, Tim, what do you attribute that to?
Well, it's the toughness Gray brings, really, in every facet of her game, including crashing the glass. Rebounding isn't something you just kind of do. You have to be committed, and Gray is.
That's just great ball movement.
And that's keyed this run, passing it with a purpose. The D has not been able to keep up.
Now, here's Carson. Rossi outside. To the middle. Here's Griner for the basket. Her 8 for 13 from the floor.
And guys, her consistent shooting, it's helped them take this lead.
Timeout. And the Liberty call time here.
Well, guys, it's all the rage to have the GOAT debate in every sport. If you're having one about the WNBA women's basketball, you start with Diana Taurasi, all-time leader in points, three-pointers. She has done it all.
Outside, pass to Johannes. Gray with it. She's covered by Taurasi. And here is Hartley over Mitchell. New York, no good that time either.
Hard work on the glass once again, guys. They've put a lot of effort into their rebounding.
And that interior play, it's made a big difference in this game.
Heads up play by Taurasi. You see the poise, you see the vision. And that's why she's one of the league's best at dishing the rock.
Now here's Hartley to the inside. Here's Wright. Yes, and it's Bria Hartley picking up the assist.
They've shown some great passing on their last few trips down the floor. You got to imagine that their coach is very happy with that.
Four straight passes leading to scores. That's just great team play.
Turner. Amanda Zawibi with the defensive effort. New York trailing here. Here's Johannes. They grab their own miss. Hartley's shot is off.
She's killing them with her poor shooting.
Here's Mitchell. Count that bucket. Here's Hartley. Pass to Zawibi. Johannes. And here is Hartley. She's covered by Taurasi. Here's Johannes. Shot clock at six. Knocked away. Out of bounds. Liberty ball as New York keeps possession. Clock is at three. Hartley's shot is off. Phoenix in the lead. Taurasi outside. It's Leilani Mitchell on the wing. Misses the three.
Well, with a clear look at the basket, she doesn't really miss a lot of those.
Inside, Zawibi. The layup missed.
You know, typically she has the touch to finish when she's in that tight. Not sure what happened there.
Here's Johannes. She's covered by Taurasi. Hartley, good.
And she had one in the first as well. And look, we all know that she can be dangerous from downtown. So the defense can't forget about her.
Now here's Taurasi. 12 points for her. The drive by Leilani Mitchell. Pass to Turner. Little. She's guarded by Wright. Stolen by Hartley. Here's Johannes. And a foul called on the shot. Got her on the way up that time, so she'll shoot two. This is her second trip to the free throw line in this one. Free throw, no good. She hits the second from the line. And so here is Phoenix. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. Passed a little. Diana Taurasi on the wing. Takes the three. It falls for her seventh bucket of the contest. She's 7 for 9 today.
With a beautiful outside stroke, Taurasi strikes fear in the eyes of her opponents.
And the Liberty call time here.
Really, guys, what separates Taurasi from the pack in terms of all-time great, her consistency. Almost every season she's played a full slate, normally averaging 20 points each night out.
Phoenix on D. They're leading by 8.
Back door. Come on.
Pass to Hartley. Here's Johannes. Just five on the clock. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. And it's the Mercury with the ball. One item that stood out is their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it's tough to defend.
Mitchell outside. And stolen by Gray. Here's Johannes. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass.
Superb assist. She was crafty, creative, and the ultimate teammate on that play.
Mitchell outside. Passed a little. Diana Taurasi on the wing. Right with the steal. Gray outside. Shoots over Little. Recovered. Now here's Hartley. Here's Gray. She's covered by Mitchell. It could go. Oh, no good on the buzzer beater. And we've reached the end of the third. It's the Mercury. They lead by six. And we're coming right back. Be sure to stay with us as we get set for the fourth quarter. And let's take this opportunity to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
I'm so happy we get to see this pass just one more time. A magnificent feed. You love to see the two kind of taking over the playmaking duties with this much skill.
Yeah, that is some dime dropping, guys. Accurate and on time.
Okay, fourth quarter of action getting underway. We've had a great one with both sides coming to play so far. Little outside. Taurasi outside. For three. In it goes for the eighth time in 10 attempts.
They've just been spraying home those threes since halftime.
And a marked improvement in their shooting from what we saw before the break.
Right outside. Pass to Charles. Now here's Hartley. She's covered by Mitchell. Hartley, good.
They've worked the ball around, and they keep finding those quality looks from mid-range.
The defense keeps backing off and waiting for them to attack the rack, but they just keep burying those pull-ups.
Take what you get. That's the simple message.
And they're making them pay.
Here's Mitchell. Tina Charles with the block.
Swatted away. Charles, one of the best ever at rejecting opponents. Incredible work rate defensively.
That's something they need to do more of. Get after it on the glass.
It certainly wouldn't hurt. Some extra possessions would definitely help narrow the gap.
Taurasi, guarded by Durr. And here's Taurasi. Shot clock at five. Little right side. And the ball out of play. The Liberty will have it. New York trailing here. Hartley outside. Outside Durr. Pass to Gray. Down low. Charles, good.
When it comes to scoring in the paint, Tina Charles is as good as anyone in the history of this league. Has every post move in the book.
Now here's Taurasi. Here's Little. And the shot is good. Here's New York now. Nurse outside. Pass to Durr. Now Charles. Hartley outside. Back to Charles. Four on the shot clock. And they double up Tina Charles. Here's Nurse. The three-pointer off the mark. Phoenix leading. Here's DeRossi. Great pass to set up the lay-in.
When you make more buckets than anybody in WNBA history, you have to score in the paint. Carassi never scared inside.
Now here's Hartley. Gray outside. Pass to Nurse to the inside. Charles. The shot comes out, and it's Phoenix the other way. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game. Bonner, good.
Defensively, they've got to start bodying them up. You know, get a little bit more physical and help your chances at winning this game.
Yeah, they're getting outclassed in the paint. And the worst part, it's at both ends of the floor.
You got to give them credit for the job they've done on the boards.
Well, guys, they've done a lot of things well, but their rebounding is right at the top of the list.
Now here's Little. Bonner with it. She's picked up by Charles. Outside. Here's Turner. She's guarded by Hartley.
She hasn't really done much on the offensive end, but she has worked within the team to help them get the lead.
Pass to Charles. Shoots over Bonner. A nice shot by Charles.
It's not just close in. Charles also flourishes in the mid-range. Unfair to stop.
And the Mercury call time here.
Some players rise to high expectations, and Tina Charles is certainly one of them. After being selected first overall in 2010, Charles was the Rookie of the Year with Connecticut.
Deciding to change it up. Here's Turner. Inside. Here's DeRossi. She makes her 10th basket of the night from the field. She has missed on three this game. And remember, that rookie season for Charles was historic. One of the best postseasons ever.
How about this number, Blake? Charles set the record for rebounds in a season during that rookie year, making a statement. She'll be a force for the WNBA for years to come. A solid performance inside. You know, they're rebounding. It's been terrific.
They're putting together a great game, aren't they? Strong performances throughout, and they've just been strong on the glass.
And it sets a tone.
And guys, the way the game is played today, more wide open, fast pace, does that put more strain on bigs physically?
Yeah, I'd say so. Running up and down the court, it's always physically draining, especially for bigs. But as the game adapts, so do the players. So I think they'll be okay in the long run.
Well, yeah, and today's WNBA players are such great athletes, so I'm not sure how much it really matters. And with all the advancements in nutrition and training and sleep, players just know how to maintain their bodies and athleticism.
Now here's Taurasi. To the paint, Bonner. Soft touch off the glass.
They continue to get it inside. The defense struggling to just contain them.
And look, when you make five in a row from in tight like they have, it also just takes pressure off of your perimeter, guys.
Great point.
Here's Boyd. Pass to Nurse. Yes, and it's Brittany Boyd picking up the assist.
Good quickness, but great length can help Nurse on drives. Allows her to get shots in areas that can't be swatted.
Now Griner. Boyd covering. Rossi outside. Back to Griner. Yes, it's good. She's made two for everyone she's missed. That's 10 of 15 in the contest. Now here's Boyd. Tight defense on her. Pass to Durr. Now here's Charles. Carson covering. Stolen by Yvonne Turner. And a fast break now for the Mercury. Carson, that's good.
They're passing the ball very crisply right now.
Their last three buckets have come by way of an assist.
Outside Boyd. Not gonna go that time. Excellent D there from Brittany Griner.
Plus eight in the rebound differential. One more reason they have absolutely just controlled this game.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative for sure.
And it started out with the rebounding. It sets a tone.
Now here's Boyd. Pass to Nurse. Back to Boyd. Sweet little floater.
Her shooting has been so good today. She may have to take it upon herself to get her team out of this hole.
Griner with the ball. Outside Carson. And here's Taurasi. Six on the shot clock. Shot from the top of the key. Rebound New York. Now Boyd. Pass to Durr. Back to Boyd. Now Zawi B. Nurse.
Count it and the foul.
Taurasi. And so she's picked up her final foul and she will sit the rest of this one out. Get a comfy seat. That's it.
The good news is they've got terrific depth at that position. If there's one spot on the floor where they can afford to lose somebody, that would be it.
Here's Turner, and if they want, they can milk the clock a little bit here.
Great point, Blake. That'd be the best option. I'd agree. You should coach.
Here's Turner. Pass to Griner. So she gets the whistle. Contact on the way up. Two shots next. It goes on Brittany Boyd.
An elite athlete for a player of her build. Griner's willing to battle on the interior.
Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good.
The top pick in the 2013 draft, Brittany Griner, had insane expectations coming into this league. And guess what? She's delivered, winning a WNBA title in 2014 and a scoring title in 2017.
That's also good, so she hits them both. And the Liberty with possession here. Down by 15. Timeout called the Liberty.
Yeah, I think the head coach saw too many easy buckets coming from inside and wanted to put a stop to it.
I would think so. If they keep giving up the kind of easy looks inside that they have been, they're in big trouble, Tim.
And they've got to change something up. Let's see what they do.
And now we have the opportunity to present our Jordan player of the game, Diana Taurasi.
Who else was even in the running? I mean, talk about unstoppable. She's been a human highlight reel.
Well, coming into this game, she had been having a rough stretch, but look, not anymore. And that's a testament to how great of a player she is.
Here's Boyd. Pass to Nurse. Charles with it. Bonner defending. A nice shot by Charles.
Tough make. You don't end up making over 2,000 baskets like Charles without some hard ones.
Mitchell outside. And here's Griner, defended by Nurse. Griner, good.
That just adds to what's probably already an insurmountable lead. I think they'll be leaving here with a win.
Yeah, hard to imagine any other outcome than the one that's staring us right in the face.
She hangs in there and cashes in on the second chance points.
There aren't many better in league history on the O board. Charles is tenacious on the glass and getting the hoop.
Here's Turner, pass to Bonner. Amanda Zawibi with the defensive effort. Asia Durr on the wing. Carson covering. Here's Boyd. To the middle. Here's Charles. And Brittany Griner with the block. Pass to Mitchell. Back to Griner. That one's in, coming off an assist from Leilani Mitchell.
Challenging shot down low, but with Griner's reach, I mean, she'll shoot those with poise.
Nurse, she's covered by Mitchell. Asia Durr on the wing. From the line, the shot's good. Here's Bonner. And so it's Phoenix easily grabbing this one. A confident win and one where they clearly showed the greater effort.
And they put on a show here at home. I think they had and felt like they had the edge and that extra confidence.
And that'll wrap it up.